You're emphasizing your Filipino connection.
No, because it's true. I owe them so much, so I really need to give it back to them as well at some point.
So how many years did you train with our friends in Berlin?
So ever since November 2020, and I won my crown in December 2022.
Yes. Yes.
So yeah, so since then, but I'm still kind of training with them, of course, and also now I try to support the girls that we are sending to compete internationally as well as possible now.
And Jasmin, I think you've discovered a lot about yourself training with Filipinos.
I did. So the duck walk training, that was when I discovered my hips will dislocate when I try to do it more. But yeah, no, I discovered a lot about myself indeed, especially personality wise, that there were some things lingering in me that I didn't know were really existing. Uh-huh. Yeah.
And I think your forte is you're being expressive. No?
I try.
Okay, well, what is your advocacy again?
So the advocacy of Miss International is cheer all women. So that means that women should support each other all the time and also spread positivity instead of negativity.
That's right. And when we cheer all women, we cheer all people.
Yes, indeed. That is actually the goal. But as beauty pageants or Miss pageants, we kind of try to have some female empowerment in them.
Okay, let's talk about the firsts, no? I think you're the first queen to wear the Miss International crown, the new Miss International crown. Looks good on you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, describe it.
So, it is very feminine in my opinion. Also, spreading the culture of Japan, of course, as the design is the sakura blossom. And what else is there to say about it? I feel very empowered when I wear it. I feel just beautiful when I wear it.
Okay, and you're the first German to win the Miss International in, I think, more than 3 decades.
Yes, it's actually not just Miss International, but also the other big 3 pageants.
Really?
Yes. Indeed, and I'm one of 6 German beauty queens to ever win a big 3 crown. Like I'm actually the 6th and I'm the 60th Miss International, and also I did some little history making there.
That's right. So that makes you a heroine of sorts in Germany.
Kind of. Well, Germany is not that big or very passionate about beauty pageants yet, but we're working on it.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, what is your message to the new? We're looking for a new Miss International, but what kind of Miss International are we looking for this time?
Someone who treats everyone with kindness and respect, and of course also stays approachable even after she wins the crown, because that is something that matters to me, for example, the most. I want people to approach me. I want them to feel like they want to talk to me, and I also want them to come to me when they need advice, for example, about something. So that is really something that is important to me and that I really want to share with the world as well, because knowledge doubles when it's shared, and of course it only benefits us all.
Okay. In being Filipino, we appreciate the fact that you're wearing Filipino terno, no?
It's embroidered.
It's so beautiful. I have worn it once before in Berlin, and wearing it in the Philippines is kind of a different feeling as well, because it really makes me feel connected to your culture even more, and that really gives me a good feeling as well.
This was made by
Manny Halasan, right?
I'm not sure. I wasn't told yet.
Yes, it's Manny Halasan. It's beautiful.
Okay. What kind of Tagalog words have you learned?
Mabuhay, maraming salamat po, kumo esta, and of course, Marites. I think that displays the good humor you people have. Look, it's Marites. there are some words that I'm not gonna say now.
You've learned the value of waiting, no?
Wait lang. I'm not ready yet.
How did you learn that?
So the Queen's Camp in Berlin is founded by Filipinos, and there's 2 main people who I'm always interacting with, and it's Nes de la Cruz Jr., who is the boss of the Queen's Camp, who is my mama Ness. He calls me anak. And then there's Mel Michael Montayes, who is our makeup artist, our catwalk coach, our stylist, our seamstress, and he literally does everything. And so every time I see them two interacting, they're usually saying like, "Wait lang." So
you know, we say that when we're stressed.
Yes, I know. Our team is still very small, so we also need to really do everything awesome. Ourselves and awesome. Yeah.
Okay, we're really glad that you speak very good English. No, I think you've been an interpreter. No, you're a polyglot. No?
Yes, kind of. So I speak Estonian, German, and English fluently, and I have been learning some languages in the past. So I've learned Spanish, French, and Latin. So I still understand these languages, but through not speaking them on a daily basis, I lost them. And so when I try to make a sentence, I usually mix Spanish and French. So I just keep it to myself. But English, Estonian, and German are completely fluent.
And we're really glad that you have a strong background in the philosophy and the history, world history.
Yes. So mostly I've been focusing on German history because, of course, I live in Germany, and that is most of seminars are about that. But at the same time, I have been learning some world history as well. So I also really like to visit museums and also cultural sites like archaeological sites or monuments.
Very good, very good.
And that really gives me an insight about what a country has been through before. And of course, every country has their own philosophers and spokespeople as well. I believe that if you learn about the culture and arts of a country, you get a big insight on what this country is built on and what this country has been through.
Okay. Our expression of thanks to everyone on a final note.
So, I really want to see and meet every one of you at the Bining Bining Filipinas finals in the Araneta Coliseum on Sunday. And so, while I'm here, please come and say hi to me.
Thank you so much. And you deserve all the happiness. I mean that. Yes.